this progress for nearly, well, about a year and a half now. She's reported on it for CNN and written a moving article you can see at CNN.com, and she joins us now at the iDesk. Thanks so much for being with us. Let me ask you, first of all, just to look at her, it takes your breath away. What was it like for you to actually meet her?
Well, the first time I met her was absolutely shocking because I didn't expect to see her, and she literally barged into the office where I was sitting. And so it was shocking on so many levels. But over the course of 16 months, observing her sporadically, both in New York and in Maryland, where she is now, it was heartbreaking, but moving and inspiring. You know, I wasn't able to actually talk to her for a year, so it was really fly on the wall reporting and just observing her. It kind of felt like anthropological field work in a way.
Now, no one could ever understand what she endured, being tortured and disfigured that way. But let's hear a little bit more from your report, because I want to ask you about her.
When she's bored, she's going to the playground. There is the swing, and she loves to swing. As a child, she loves it.
So whatever it is I liked from childhood, I still like that.
Day by day, she's getting more comfortable. Yeah, obviously, everybody has moments, you know. We all know it, that one.
I think all the time, why this thing happens to me? Yeah, why they cut my ear and nose? If I had my nose, I could have my life now.
It's heartbreaking, and yet to see that image of her swinging on a swing like a child, she's 22 years old. What kind of shape is she in emotionally?
Well, she is very childlike. This is someone who sees an ice cream truck and runs after it.
I mean, she's, age 22.
Yeah, she's very childlike. She had never gone to school a day in her life. She came to the U.S. knowing so little. She did not even know there were days of the week. So she came here, you know, having been tortured the way she was tortured and with so little in terms of an education or, you know, knowledge of the world. But she has come a long way. When she first arrived, she regressed horribly. No one expected her to regress as badly as she did. She threw these violent tantrums. She had what they called faux seizures, where she would pull out her hair and bite herself. But she has really evened out a lot.
But she is still disfigured. And so someone watching this will think she's surrounded by people who are trying to help her. She's living in an affluent country with wonderful medical care. Mm-hmm. Why hasn't she had the surgery to make herself look more normal and fit in more normally among others?
Right. A lot of people ask that. And Aesha needs to be emotionally ready for this surgery. It will be grueling. It can take anywhere from 9 months to 2 years to complete what they have to do to her. And so she needs to be cleared by psychiatrists. She has moved 3 times since she's been here, and each time there have been different teams of doctors working with her. And so now the family who has her now, they hope that she can start the surgery process soon. But again, she needs to be emotionally ready, and they need to know she can handle it.
This is something more complicated than just a simple happy ending. We wish it were, but Jessica Ravitz, it's extraordinary reporting about a remarkable young woman who's she's just getting through this. And you can read more about Aisha's journey on our website at cnn.com/Aesha. And you'll find the link to the organization Women for Afghan Women, dedicated to protecting and empowering women and girls. Jessica Ravitz, thanks
so much
for this.